Now, 3 weeks before Marilyn died, photographer George Barris unknowingly captured some of her last moments before camera. Our television and movie critic George Kirgo caught up with Barris in Los Angeles, and the photographer talked about his memories of those final days.
She was really down to earth, and it was kind of hard to believe that here you are working with the most beautiful, famous woman in the world as far as being a movie star and a person. And she was very cooperative. She would do anything that she felt would help in whatever pictures we were taking. And she was just as warm as could be. She kept a champagne glass with her. And she didn't drink as much as people said she did. She very seldom, it was sort of like a prop. She was warm. She was very cooperative. And in fact, there were a lot of times when you'd feel that she was taking the pictures herself. I mean, she would say, look, I've got an idea. What do you think about it? And they were always good ideas. Always good ideas. And this was a girl that loved the camera. She really did.
George, Marilyn left Hollywood, went to New York to work at the Actors Studio. She wanted to be taken seriously as an actress. And then she came back, and here are these final photographs in, I see an intensity and a depth in her eyes that I hadn't seen before, but they're also kind of sexy. I mean, how could she do that after the way she spoke, and or was she just having a good time?
She was having a good time, and also I said to Marilyn, look, you're a beautiful woman, and the world wants to see a woman of 36 that looks as great as you do. And she said, if you think so, fine. She was very cooperative. She realized the fact that being a woman and being beautiful, that it was her obligation to the world to not hide it. And it was something she was proud of. We all are proud that she, at 36, looked at, like a 16-year-old in some of these pictures.
Tell me about the last photograph you took of Marilyn Monroe.
The last picture that I took of Marilyn, there was just one frame left in the camera. And the sun was just about going down, and we were on the beach. And it was getting kind of chilly, and Marilyn started to shake a little bit. And I said, Marilyn, this is the last picture I'm going to take of you. And she said, do we have to? And I said, please, it's the last frame, and let's make it a picture that everyone will remember and that you would be proud of. So she was sitting on the sand. We had this Scandinavian heavy sweater she was wearing. She bundled up and she had covered her knees with the blanket. She leaned forward and she said, all right, George, and this is just for you. And she puckered her lips and threw a kiss to me. And she said, this is for you and the world, and this is the picture I want to be remembered by. And Marilyn, who was Norma Jean, always will live in our hearts.
On Wednesday, art publisher Edward Weston is presenting an exhibit of George Barris's pictures and 1,000 more by other photographers at the Bellage Hotel in Hollywood. Proceeds will benefit AIDS Project Los Angeles. The exhibit will then tour the country.
Goodbye, Norma Jean. No, I never knew you at all. You have the grace to hold yourself by those around you. Marilyn Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would like to love you, but I would just be the candle burned out long ago. Candle burned out long before the legend ever did.
Coming up next, we'll have Money Watch with Betsy Ashton, plus comedian Kathy Ladman. Stay with us.
Never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in.
out for a celebrity preview of a photography exhibition of Miss Monroe. Featured are works by Milton Green, Bert Stern, and George Barris. Many are originals. Some were taken in the last weeks before her death by a drug overdose at age 36. The exhibition is at the Bel Air Hotel in Hollywood. It opens to the public on Wednesday.